Let us do a meditation. Sit. Close your eyes. Asato ma. Sadgamaya. Tamaso ma. Jyotirgamaya. Mrityorma. Amritam gamaya. Om Shanti. Shanti, Shanti. Nanu, Nanembudu, Nanalla, Ideha, Manabutti, Nanalla, Sachidanandatma, Shivanandani, Shivoham, Shivoham, Shivoham. I'm not the body. I'm not the mind, I'm not the intellect, I'm pure consciousness, Shoswarupi. When I close my eyes, I'm able to experience the body, experience the mind, experience the thoughts. If I very closely observe the body is constantly changing. From childbirth to death, body is continuously changing. What is body? Body is nothing but changing sensations. If I scan my body from head to toe, inch by inch, I observe that there are sensations rising and falling, appearing and disappearing. Body is a flow of sensations. There is no solid entity called body. Every moment, millions of cells in the body die, millions of cells are born. Body is a flow of energy. But I am the witness, unchanging reality, able to observe the changing body. What is changing is asatya, mithya, unreal. Changing is the energy pattern. We gave a name and form to the changing energy pattern and call it as body. There's no entity called body. From birth to death, what do you call as body? So you say, body is my photograph. Photograph is one instance of the body. When things are changing, can you say, what is body? Body appears in the waking state. In the waking state also, it's changing constantly. When you go to dream state, the body disappears. Dream body appears. After dream state, deep sleep you go, dream body also disappears. No body is there in deep sleep. What appears and disappears is like magic. Magician pulls out a rabbit from his hat. It's just an appearance. Similarly, body appears in the waking state. When you go to sleep, it disappears. Dream body appears, dream body disappears. What appears and disappears is mithya, asatya. I am the witness, observer of that, satya. So changing reality is called asat, unchanging reality is called satya. So this is called nitya anitya viveka. Asato ma sadgamaya means this. Tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, from darkness to light. What is darkness to light? I am experiencing the mind. Mind is a bundle of thoughts which appear and disappear continuously. There's nothing called mind. Mind is a flow of thoughts. There's no solid entity called mind. A flow of thought appears like a continuous entity, like pictures in a movie, still pictures when you run, it appears like a movie. There's nothing called movie. Still pictures put one after the other. Mind is like that. Thought is between name and form. Name and form is always about the past. Past recording. At this moment, there's nothing called mind. No mind is real. I am the witness of the mind. Mind is the object. I am the subject. Body is the object. I am the subject. The real subject is Sakshi, Atma. This is called Atma, Anatma Viveka. As you become aware of the mind, deeper and deeper layer of the mind opens up. Subconscious comes to conscious. When I don't react, the subconscious impressions just disappear after coming to consciousness. In that process, I become aware of the total mind, conscious mind, subconscious mind, and unconscious mind. So awareness of the mind in totality is called Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, from darkness to light. Right now, I'm not aware of unconscious part of mind or subconscious part of mind. I'm only aware of the conscious part of mind. Gradually, I become aware of the mind at the deeper level. Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya. Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya. Then I realize I am the Sakshi. Sakshi is deathless Atma, birthless Atma. Body and mind appear and disappear. There is no death from me. I am eternal. Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. When I realize this truth, I attain supreme peace, Parashanti. Sit as a witness. Be aware of the sensation of the body or breath. Any thought or feeling or emotions comes, let it come and grow. It's all mithya. Be aware of changing sensation of body or breath. Because body and breath are in present moment, thoughts are always about the past. Stay in the present moment reality. Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamuduchate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Nanu Nanembudu Nanalla Ide Manabuddhi Nanalla Sachidanandatma Shivananda. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಎರಡು ಕೈಗಳನ್ನು ಕಣ್ಣ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಉಜ್ಜಿ, ಕಣ್ಣನ್ನು ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಶಾಖ ಕೊಡಿ, ಕಣ್ಣನ್ನು ತೆರೀರಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್, ಟು ಬಿ ಎ ವಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅನ್ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್. ರೈಟ್ ನೌ ಅನ್ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಿಡನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಿಡನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಅಸ್? ವಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಎನಿಬಡಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್? ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಇದೆಯಾ ಝೂಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ? ಅನ್ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆಯಾ? ಎಸ್ ವಿಪಿನ್, ಯಾವ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್?
ಹರಿ ಓಂ ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ.
ಎಸ್ ವಿಪಿನ್, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಹಿಯರ್?
ಎಸ್
ಆರ್ ಯು ಎಬಲ್ ಟು?
ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಗುರುಜಿ, ಎಸ್ ಗುರುಜಿ, ಆಮ್ ಐ ಆಡಿಬಲ್ ಸರ್?
ಎಸ್ ವಿಪಿನ್, ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ನೌ. ಎಸ್
All right. Guruji, my question is regarding intuition, in which in the graphics it was mentioned that soul functions spontaneously, and there is one part written creativity. Please give us an example, Guruji, how intuition and creativity come about.
So the question is intuition, how it functions. First is you have to understand the word of spontaneous. Spontaneous means there is no ego functioning. Okay, for example, our breath is going on up and down. It's a spontaneous functioning. It is, there's no, I'm not the doer. Right?
Yes.
Suppose I want to talk now. They say talker is required. Ego is required. But for breathing, there's no doer there. Correct? So what happens in the mind, ego part functions for conscious function in the world, where
correct.
I have to do this, I don't have to do this thing, right? But a artist gets the inspiration. I cannot force inspiration.
Okay.
The inspiration appears spontaneously, right? So okay. Let us say Tyagaraja has done a kirtana. Saints, many poet saints have done a kirtana, song.
Correct.
The song happens when the singer is not there.
Okay.
Then what happens? Spontaneously happening. The consciousness operating on the mind, the singing happens.
All right.
Understand? That's a spontaneous.
Yes.
Mind only operates. Mind only, higher part of the mind, operates without an ego.
Okay.
Right? For example, child has no ego, but it cannot sing a music, it cannot create a art. The person has evolved, he has become an artist. So now, if he is able to drop the ego, a beautiful art form can come through him. That's spontaneous. That's why if you understand, all our temples are there, beautiful temples are there, right? They do beautiful sculpture. Shiva, all the sculptures they do. Do you know what they do? Before this Shilpi, the sculptor, sits in front of the stone.
Okay.
He closes and meditates. He prays to Shiva. Oh Shiva, you please operate to me and make yourself. So the Shilpi disappears. The higher consciousness operates through him and beautiful sculpture comes out. As long as there is a doer, as long as the enjoyer, there is always no other, ego is operating. When the doer, knower, enjoyer disappears, the consciousness operates on the mind, and that's called intuition.
All right.
Does it make it clear or confusing?
Yeah, no, it is quite clear. Guruji, it is quite clear. My second question, Guruji, is that please give us like the service that you are providing, that is a great example.